If you need any FIFA 19 Ultimate Team coins, check out MuleFactory.com. They're cheap and reliable, very, very fast serviced, and also use my discount code IHAS5 when checking out to get a decent discount. What is up? Welcome to episode number 9 of Trading to 1 Million Coins. Again, thank you for the support on the channel. We are closing on 90,000 subscribers. So I mean the world, if you could hit that subscribe button down below, help me get to 100k. So, the pin comment from last video was sent in from Tom Games Whitey, and he said, is the bronze pack method working this year? And what you guys are going to find out in this video is the answer to that question. Is the bronze pack method working? I'm going to try it out, do it live, no cuts, just see if we make coins with it. Also, if you want to have your chance to be the pin comment on the next video, all you have to do is just drop a comment down below. I'll pick one comment that I will be pinning, and it is as simple as that. So we started this episode with 33,000 coins because I did in fact make those investments last episode, and then I did some sniping with one of the brand new SBCs. I believe it was for the Erders V, but that was the challenge and you needed a couple players from that league. My filter here was Erders V and forward, I believe, just to get these snipes. So you can see all of these players I did pick up, they were going for different prices. So like De Jong there, picking him up, selling him for 1,500 coins. He was one of the cheaper players. Like this card here, he was worth about 3,000 coins. Jorgsen, he was basically one of the cheaper ones again, about 1.4k, but again, still decent profit. And then we get to like Kuas here. He was actually worth quite a bit as well. I could sell him for about 1.6k. But all of these snipes, I was picking these cards basically all up for under like 1.2k or cheaper. And I was making very, like Masonda here, I could sell him for 1.9k, and I'm picking those cards up for like 850 coins. I was nearly making 1,000 coins per card, and you can see some of the cards are selling on instantly. And leading on from that, so I listed up all those cards, and sometimes you get that sort of glitch where you buy a load of cards on FIFA that if you re-log onto Ultimate Team, like where you buy the cards and they don't show in your transfer list, so you have to relaunch Ultimate Team. That did happen. So all of those cards sold on, we're at 44,000 coins, so already made an 11k profit. But there were cards which I'd picked up and just they disappeared. So this actually, I came back a bit later and some of the prices did start to drop. So like my Masonda here, I could have sold him on for like 2,000 coins, but I only could sell him on for like 1,000 coins just because of the price. So my tip here is when you snipe players, make sure you list them up like as soon as possible. And also, make sure to relog Ultimate Team if you've bought a load of cards and send them all to the transfer list, because 9 times out of 10, you'll have like some like missing or like hidden cards. So relist that random bronze. He will sell eventually. And our cards did sell on. We're sat at 50,000 coins. So he made a 17k profit in a quick sniping session, which is pretty decent. But now we're going to test if the bronze pack method is working. So you see here on the console, we do have 50,000 coins. So the test, what I'm going to do, I'm going to open 10 bronze packs. So we're going to spend 4,000 coins and we're going to see how much we do in fact get back. And I've got a list of some things out things to look out for some of the SBCs. So like Liverpool players in the Greek or the Hellas League. We have that Championship League SBC. We also have the Argentinian one. We have the Player of the Month, a couple of Brazilian players. And there were brand new marquee matchups that literally came out about an hour ago. So a lot of players to look out for, 10 packs, and we only need over 4,000 coins to make a profit. And for the players who aren't worth much now, I might actually just store them in my club, because this is like the good thing about this method. Eventually, the card will be used, pretty much. For like most cards, eventually it will be used. So it's just that thing of waiting to see like for that SBC, like the specific one you need to come at. So you can see here, out of those players, no one's really worth anything. We got the kits, the badges. I'm just going to discard everything except the actual players, and then I'll just keep the players in the club for the future in case we do get an SBC. So we started on, 50,000 coins basically. Going to spend 4k, see if we can in fact make a profit. And I'd say the 400 coin bronze packs are the better ones to do. Like, you don't get as many rare cards, but you can do, like, you can still get some cards who are worth a bit. So this guy here, 300 coins, 200 coins, 1.9. So he isn't worth too much, but like it's looking more promising because there wasn't too many of his card on the market. This card worth 200. This card here worth 200. If you guys don't have that many coins on the like on FIFA, What you can actually do is just list every item for 200 coins and keep relisting them, and eventually somebody will buy them. So like a bronze squad fitness card, they sell for about 600 coins. So I'm going to get 600 coins back on that gold squad fitness. The rest of the cards I'm just going to quick sell, and then I'll put the other cards in the club. So we've got back 600 coins. We've spent 800, but we do have those players and the quick sell value. So this is pack number 3. I'm going to go through these a bit faster, just showing you guys what it is. So we've got Nottingham here. He looks a bit more promising. He's a bronze rare card, 500, 200 coins. So he's not worth too much. This Thomas Asante, 400 coins, 500 coins, 200. Like, I could probably sell him for maybe 300, 200 coins. I'm going to list him up for about, I'll go 450. Maybe a lazy buy will pick him up. Again, with this Nottingham guy, I'll list him for about 350. You don't always have to list them for minimum. Some people are just like lazy buyers, and again, they will just buy your card for whatever, really. So I list these cards up for a bit, like 300 coins, just a little bit over, because maybe somebody will pick them up. And the rest of the cards, it's not really looking too promising. So those can get, I'll keep the player. You always want to keep the players in case they do get used in some SBCs. So pack number 4, we're nearly halfway there. We started with 50k. We should be able to get like one player surely who is worth like over 1,000 coins. So looking at it, Polish, German, Saudi Arabian. It's not looking too promising so far out of these players, to be honest. Kruger, 700 coins. He might be worth something. 500, 300 coins, 500, 350. So we could probably get 400 coins out of him. He might take a while to sell on, but we will get some coins there. Again, I'll quick sell the rest of the cards. Keep the players in the club for a future SBC. And I believe this is now pack number 5. We're halfway there. And so far, in theory, after this pack, we should have got 2,000 coins back, which I don't really think we have yet. Like, if I would sell every player I've stored in the club, we could do. But I'm looking for a player like this. We pick up one. So 10,000, 10,000, 7,000, 4,000, 3K, 2K, 1.8. Just to prove that these methods do work, I will sell him at 1,500 coins. Like, I could have kept him and then sold him on for a bit more later, but I'll just prove that the method does work. So he will sell on for 1,500. This random card is a rare. Yeah, I'll list that for 200 coins to give bonus passing. So just off that pack there, we got back 1,500 coins. We're 1K down, but our card hasn't actually sold yet. So we spent 2k on 5 packs, we got back 1.5k and a load of players. So already from that first 5, we are in profit, just it's not really the biggest. I want to basically get one player who is worth like a good couple, like 5,000 coins maybe. And like this card here, I could sell him for about 800, but I'll go 750 to make sure he sells on. David Gill here, he is not worth much. This random guy, here we go, 2.5k bid. 2.7k, and that is it. So this card, he has a 2.5k bid. I'll list him up for 2.3k. He will sell on straight away. So and basically already we have paid for the packs. This was pack number 6, and we are already basically in profit. So quick sell those items there. We have 4 more packs. I hope I'm counting right. I believe I've opened 6. If I open one extra, it's not the end of the world. So this is pack number 7 now. And is anybody good? Jacobson, 2k, 1.8k, 1.6, 1.2. So we could sell him for 1,000 coins easily. Again, profit on this pack. It cost us 400 coins. We've already got 1,000 back. He's not worth anything. He's not worth anything. Manager isn't. Well, this manager, he's a bronze, but he's rare. So I'll list him up. So that's 7 packs. I want to keep the players, just in case. 7 packs there. And now we have 3 more to go. Like, we're already basically back at that 50k, and we have 3 packs left to make some more profit. So here, this pack, who do we get? I want to get one player in the Greek league, and then they are worth a lot. Or like a Liverpool player, that is a very good pack ball. So these cards, 10k, 10k, 3k, 200 coins. Is he actually worth anything? Well, his minimum buy now is about 3,000. There's one card for 200 coins. You know what? I'm going to pick this card up. Oh, no, someone's already bought it. I guess I'm not. I'll list him. Well, his minimum was about 3K. I'll list him for 2.4. Hanek here, 600 coins, 500, 400. I'll list him for about, we'll go like 300 coins there. And then the rest of the cards, I will just quick sell. So that was pack 8. Two more to go. We're already at 51. Like, we've already made 1,000 coins profit off these packs. And, like, this trading method is fun. You can sit here, just open packs. I guess it's not as exciting as, like, opening real packs. Or, like, gold packs where you can get, like, some crazy pack balls. But you're making profit. So this card, there was one for 200, but the next cheapest was about 700. So I'll list them for 550. We've made profit on this pack already. This card here, 500 coins is his minimum. We'll list him up for 450 there. That's already like, we've doubled our coins on this pack. Balgamart, 700, 400, 300, 250. I'll list him for 300 coins he might sell on. And then we got a player, England, Sessegnon, and he must be worth something. 1.4, 1.2. We will list him up for 1,000 coins. So, well, 900 coins. And we got an 100 coin redeem. Like, literally, from that pack, what did we make? Like, 2,000 coins? Pretty much, like, we paid 400. We made, like, 2,000 coins. And I've completely lost count. I believe this is the last pack. I might have done one extra, or maybe one less, but I've already shown we're in the profit. And this last pack, any players in the Greek League? No. That is like the one thing. Okay. Dismet. 6K. 4K. This one player alone has paid for my 10 packs. Just think of it that way. I got one player and that paid for my 10 packs. Worst case, I could have quick sold everything else and I still would have like broke even. But literally that one player paid for my packs. This healing card will sell on there. And then I will quick sell the rest of these. But you can list all the other stuff up for 200 coins, but I just don't really think it's worth it. And here, transfer list, 8 items sold. Look at all these cards. Just right there. We're at 53,000 coins. We started this episode with 50k. I opened 10 bronze packs. And we've already made 3,000 coins profit. And the rest of the cards, we got 450, 350, 400 coins. 2k on him, 500, 300, 4,000 coins there, and then an extra 2. Like, from these packs, we'll probably be at, like, 58,000 coins, which, like, we opened 10 bronze packs, and we made nearly, like, 8k. That's absolutely stupid. Like, I've nearly made 1,000 coins per pack just from that luck. It's actually mad. But, yeah, let me know. Try it out for yourself. Make sure you check every player to compare price. Like, some players will be used now, some players will be used later, maybe next week for the marquee matchup. So keep all the players in your club. But that's about it from me. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you did enjoy. And I'll see you on my next video.